It's time for 5 Good Minutes with ESPN NBA analyst Brian Windhorst here on the ESPN Cleveland social media platforms. I'm Matt Fontani. He's Danny Cunningham. Of course, Windy, very busy on the road. NBA playoffs going on. And, you know, Windy, it's funny as we saw Memphis get escorted out of the playoffs not too long ago. Then it comes out, which I want to get your thoughts on, just Memphis straight up coming out saying we're not taking Dillon Brooks back at all. But all of a sudden, Windy, the Cavs are a betting favorite to get Dillon Brooks. Does he fit this team? Could you see any possible world that he would make sense for the Cavs? And your thoughts on Memphis straight up saying we don't want him anymore?
Well, they didn't say it publicly. I think they told him privately and it got public. It is an unusual position to take, and I wouldn't 100% rule out that he wouldn't go and work with them on a sign and trade, because it's not good business to operate like that, and Memphis is good business people generally. But I can see why they've kind of made that decision. And I think the key thing is, I think one of the things is because he wanted significantly more money than they were willing to pay. And so keep in mind, the Cavs have about $12 million that they can use in free agency with a mid-level exception. And quite frankly, I think Dillon Brooks is going to want more. But okay, if you want to argue that he may not get it because his market may be limited, I actually think he will get it more. You know, I don't think he moves the ball forward for the Cavs, because I think he's a more expensive Isaac Okoro. Now, he is a good defensive player. He's a slightly better defensive player, but he will cost way more money, and he will, I don't think be great in the locker room. That said, it is difficult to acquire players who have value. If you could get him on $12 million, I would probably take him as long as Donovan Mitchell was okay with it. But if I did, I would be taking him knowing I was going to try to trade him and just create the value. I would be surprised if he would sign for longer than 1 year on that type of deal. I think my guess would be he would want a 1 year and a player option. So I don't think it's a match. I think someone you would be watching in the series I'm covering right now would be more interesting, and that would be Grant Williams with the Boston Celtics, who is more of a 3-4. Excellent corner three-point shooter, one of the better corner three-point shooters in the NBA, has shown he can defend multiple different positions, and is a guy who I'm not sure the Celtics are going to be able to afford. He's restricted. They have matching rights. If you offer the mid-level for Grant Williams, you might be able to get him. I think he might even be able to get, you know, more than that because the market's so tight. So I would be way more interested in having either Grant Williams and Dillon Brooks, because you can play both ends of the court.
Brian, obviously we know the Cavs do need to upgrade on the wing in some capacity. What do you think that market, other than Dillon Brooks and Grant Williams, is going to look like this summer?
It's thin. You know, another guy that I would put on the list, again, because I'm not sure his team can pay him, would be Max Strus, who you've been maybe watching with the Miami Heat. Excellent shooter, not awesome on defense, but can hold his own, and would be the exact type of player the Cavs would need. But the Heat are right up against the luxury tax line, and I'm not sure that they want to muck up their books. They have Duncan Robinson on there, who's making so much money. I don't know if they can afford to have two guys like that on there. So that's the type of guy. Like, again, I would like Max Strus or Grant Williams more than Dillon Brooks, because those guys shoot. Forget about all the other stuff with Dillon Brooks. If a guy can't shoot, quite frankly, I don't want to spend the asset on him. And I think that's really the way Cavs fans should be thinking, because I'm pretty sure that's the way the Cavs front office is thinking.
And Brian, we know the NBA awards announced, and a second team All-NBA for Donovan Mitchell, a first team All-Defensive accolade for Evan Mobley. I saw the youngest player in NBA history to do that. Brian, thoughts on those two accolades for Donovan and Evan? And then a question we thought we'd have fun with you and see what you think. Who has a better chance to make All-NBA next year, Donovan Mitchell or Evan Mobley?
Good question. Well, boy, would the Cavs love to have Evan Mitchell in the Evan Mobley in the conversation for All-NBA. That would be a pretty gigantic step forward. I do think he's got that kind of skill. I think that, you know, Donovan has made All-NBA in the past. There's only been a handful of guys in the history of the Cavs who've made All-NBA. Other than LeBron, I think it's a real short list. I think Kyrie made it 1 year. Mark Price maybe made it. I'm not sure if Sean Kemp made it. That's a pretty great accomplishment for Donovan to make second team and to be able to acquire a guy that's second team All NBA. I mean, that's really impressive. I know he didn't play his best basketball in the playoffs. I think if Evan Mobley got votes for All NBA next year, that would be a pretty impressive step forward. There's a pretty big gulf from where he is now about where he needs to go. But, you know, typically players like him, his offense, you know, should develop a little bit as he gets older. It's harder to develop defense than it is to develop offense. And so the fact that he's already really ahead of his years in defense, I think, gives him a chance. And it would be great. You know, the thing about it is, if he makes All NBA next year, he gives himself a chance to sign for a lot more money when he becomes a free agent. So he definitely will be incentivized to do so.
We appreciate it, Brian. Enjoy the games tonight, Friday, all of that. And we'll join everybody next week right here on 5 Good Minutes with ESPN NBA analyst Brian Windhorst on the ESPN Cleveland social media platforms.